One of the medicines that are used by women is oxytocin. Oxytocin is a very unstable product, and it's very, it's impacted a lot by heat. And so when you go to many of the places where this medicine is actually given to women, typically the storage conditions are not that great, meaning that it's not stored in a refrigerator as it should, and as a result, the product degrades. And when if a woman was to get actually a product that's been degraded, most of the time the amount of medicine that's supposed to be there will not. So as a result, the patient, or the woman in this case, will not actually get the full impact of that particular product, of that particular medicine, in terms of this, how much should be administered. And this has been a problem for many, many years. And it's one of the, you know, the areas that we found in terms of women in particular, that if they don't get good quality oxytocin, they can actually eventually die from postpartum hemorrhaging. As I mentioned, one of the problems with oxytocin is it's being able to ensure its quality throughout the supply chain. So basically what that means is you want to make sure you can maintain the integrity of the supply chain and keeping it stored cold. In Nigeria, we've been working with a local manufacturer to produce oxytocin injection. But in addition to also helping them manufacture a good quality product, they've also been looking at how to ensure the integrity of the supply chain, meaning that the product that they make, once it leaves their manufacturing facility and goes to the storage facilities that are the distributors, as well as the final endpoint or the last mile, that whole length of supply chain, they've actually put in practices to make sure that that product is stored in the cold chain. And as a result, this is actually helping address that issue related to oxytocin, meaning the issue about its instability and being not stored in the cold chain. So local manufacturing has been successful thus far in making sure that, you know, women actually get good quality oxytocin. The take-home message I would like everyone to really think about, to take with them, is that for us to achieve the quality outcomes that we want to achieve, we need to have quality medicines along with quality services.